Yes, thank you, Mr. Speaker. And the first thing I want to do is to congratulate Mr. Allen on that speech, which I thought was excellent. I welcome this motion, personally. It's not because I want to see the same thing brought back to the Assembly time after time, but it's a simple motion. It's very straightforward. It calls on the Assembly to bring forward legislation, which is, I mean, you think about it, the only time we will effectively decide this matter is when legislation is brought forward. Anything prior to that is important, but it's shadow boxing. What we have today is a short motion that will provide at least a test of opinion as to what the House feels about this, and my feeling is that the House will this time perhaps vote in favour of the motion. I did hear Mr. Campbell on the Nolan show recently complaining that this motion had suffered from a lack of detail, which I must say made me laugh, because you can almost infer from that that if it had been sufficient detail, they might have considered it, but I mean, that's clearly ridiculous. But as I say, the time to scrutinise this would be when legislation is brought forward. And the fact that we have a petition of concern today is equally ridiculous. A petition of concern on a private member's motion, it doesn't change the vote. It doesn't change by a single vote what the outcome of this will be today. So I wish we could get to the point where, you know, parties could perhaps rely on a three-line whip and forget about petitions of concern. This is an equality issue for the Alliance Party. Yes, sure.
Appreciate the member giving way. Given that this is a motion that therefore doesn't carry any weight, why does the members or those who propose this not bring forward a private member's bill? Because it's asking the executive to bring forward legislation, and for as long as our party has the ability within that executive to control things, there won't be legislation from the executive. So why don't members bring forward a bill with the detail rather than a motion that is constantly used to try and bring forward this issue?
Yes, thank you, Mr. Speaker. I thank the member for his intervention. That's a fair point. I think he's perhaps asking the wrong member. I'm a fairly recent convert to this point of view, as everybody knows, and it may well be that somebody following today's vote, if it is in favour, will think it worthwhile to bring forward a bill. I certainly hope that they do. As I was about to say, this is an equality issue for the Alliance Party. And it's an equality issue for me, but in fairness to those who I know oppose this, and you know, I can hardly criticise them too roundly, because they're in the position that I've been on four previous votes. So I have a lot of respect for their view. I don't agree with it anymore, but I have to respect the fact that, in Mr. Campbell's terms, a journey is a journey. Some people take longer to get there than others. And I don't agree that a journey has to have a final destination. We're all on a journey through life. I'm a wee bit pressed here. As I say, it's an equality issue, but you can't divorce it from matter of conscience. It is clearly also a matter for personal conscience. We're all come under pressure from our instincts, from our upbringing, from our churches, if you belong to a church. And all those pressures come to bear. And I would say at this point, Mr. Speaker, that some of the pressures that have been applied in this particular situation through Twitter and through websites on a particular member of my party, not myself, has been absolutely disgraceful and out of order. That's all I want to say about that. Mr. Nesbitt has been often quoted for his wrong side of history point, and that the younger generation won't understand what this Assembly is about. Well, this Assembly has the opportunity today to get on the right side of history and to recognise the strength of feeling that's out there amongst the population. No. Well, then you're not disappointed. As I say, I'm under pressure of time here, Mr. Speaker. I believe in equality. I believe in equality under the law. And that equality, for me, extends to everybody in our society. It extends to the minority groups we all know about under Section 75. In this particular context, it extends to gay people, LGBT. I took a while to come to terms with civil partnerships way back then. The journey has been long for me, but I am now where I am. I'm satisfied and comfortable with the position that I'm now taking. I believe in civil partnerships. I believe the gay couple should be able to adopt. I have no problem whatsoever with blood donation from anybody. And I can't see how I can continue to hold a position against civil marriage if I believe to equality under the civil law. So that's where I stand. Lord Morrow asked what is a marriage, and Mr. Alistair made silly points about polygamy. Marriage is the union of two people who love each other. That's it. And the only question here is whether we extend that beyond man and woman to include two people of the same sex. I think it's now time that we took that challenge in hand and dealt with it. So I support the motion, Mr. Speaker.